Port of Miami. It's been a journey. Ain't nothing changed. A little stronger, a little wiser. Maybe a little more. Blame it on America.
I'm pulling off the lot, I bought it cash. Whoa. Her future bright, don't give nobody bad. Whoa. Be looking good inside this. Whoa. But I notice that she missing all the edges. Whoa. I run the game just by running with the running. Whoa. Pro attitude, they got rich calisthenics. Whoa. Walking in the courtroom, sipping on the beverage. Whoa. I know the judge, so I got a lot of leverage. Whoa. Rapping a cappella. Whoa. Kim Trezor, people with the weather. Whoa. I got it. Boy, don't make me be the devil. Whoa. He knocking on the door and know the password. Gave me his blessings while I'm hotter than the last verse.
Dead presidents, dead presidents. Dead presidents, dead presidents.
Let's go, let's go, let's go. All my little militant. Let's go, let's go, let's go. I'm innocent.
Dead presidents. In the bathtub, get some house shoes. I got money, I got war wounds. Get the cushion on that, ain't no dance moves. I was busted on the stoop, hanging with my Haitians. On the news, on front pages, ain't no relations. I was taking Ben Franklin, bustin', 2 times in a row, that's a repeat. You in the. Cause they easy. I'm gonna freeze me. She got a, she love me like she need me. I got my Maybach flooded out with extra TVs. I make her pick up every single.
Hello everybody, I'm Larry Ridley. Welcome to Madden 18 on EA Sports. Tonight's matchup features two quarterbacks who will be trying to lead their team to victory. It's Rivers' Chargers going up against Smith's Chiefs.
Well, Larry, the baseball regular season is wrapping up across the parking lot, but football season in full swing now at Arrowhead Stadium. The scene a few moments ago, here it is. It's unlike any other in sport as both teams made their way out of the tunnel. These folks are fired up as their guys are ready to do battle between the Los Angeles Chargers and the Kansas City Chiefs. In motion, the tight end, Kelsey. On first down, Smith. And this one caught by Travis Kelsey. And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39. That goes for a Chiefs first down, 14 yards.
A lot of tight ends just use their size and their strength, try to occupy some space and kind of body people away and catch the football. But not this guy. He's a refined route runner. Makes me wonder if he took some dance classes in his background with his footwork.
In motion, the tight end, Kelsey. They'll bring the tight end in motion right. On first and 10, Smith. That's out to Hill, right side complete. And he'll get up to the 43-yard line. The completion good for 3, and it's second down.
The goal of a wide receiver screen is get enough blockers in front to create a wall and let him pick his spot to run the football. How about the defense there, swarming to it and not allowing that to happen? Did not let him get downfield.
To throw on second down is Smith. To the right side, it's Kelsey. And he'll be brought down at the 48-yard line. 9 yards on the pickup there, and it keeps the drive alive.
I like the screen being called here early in the game, especially on the opening drive, because, Brandon, when guys come out of the locker room, especially those pass rushers, they are so amped up to get to the quarterback that you can use that against them, and a screen pass is a great way of doing it.
And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Tyler Davison. He's the one that got to him. He takes him down for a loss of 9. Second down, here's Smith. The tight end Kelsey has it over the middle. And he takes this one down all the way near the 30. A really nice gain of 25 yards. How about the start throwing the football? 4 for 4 on this opening drive.
Oh, he's slinging it. And oftentimes when you talk about slinging it, you're thinking about a guy throwing it all over the yard, not necessarily accurately. In this case, though, he's honing in on his targets, and he's delivering.
Yeah, the opening script, however they drew it up for this first drive, going to plan so far. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. Another nice gain, 13 yards that time, and another first down. On the run, it's Ware. And after the good gain last play, as he's going to be stopped behind the line of scrimmage. Shift together here from the D-line. Here's Smith now on second down. Out to the right here to Wilson. And he's able to get it to the edge of the red zone at the 20-yard line. That throw good for only a couple. It brings up third down.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you've got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go, because he might wander into some tough coverage.
And he's brought down just outside of the 10 at the 11. 9 yards on the carry, but it's going to lead to a fourth down.
Okay, he didn't break that one all the way, but you got to know that he feels like he's right on the verge, and that's probably exactly what he's telling them in the huddle right now.
And this one is no good. He missed it. And this will remain a scoreless game. And that one, my goodness, that was almost too easy.
Yeah, you knocked out too many attempts shorter than that one. And I don't think this was blocked. That's about as bad a miss as you can have.
Rivers on first down. Henry brings it in. 14 yards is the pickup there and a Charger first down.
I do believe we'll see a little bit more of this as this game progresses, because when you can have that type of a game in the middle of the defense, it hurts them in so many ways, because most teams like to be strong down the middle. And if you can sting them there, that opens things up for you on the outside as well.
That's where he, their big tight end, is so good, that middle third, the seam routes, the in routes. Yeah, you're right. Probably see more of that.
Yeah, it takes a lot of courage and fortitude to go in the middle as well, and he's got it. This team is not going to make it easy for you. They're a physical group, and we just saw it there on that play. It came in, made the contact, just as he's trying to haul it in.
And the D-line pinching together must be expecting the run. They'll run. This is Melvin Gordon. And he'll get this only up to about the 35. It's a gain of about 3, but it's going to leave him with 3rd and still 7 yards to go. Pretty good little two-play sequence there. You force the incompletion, then a very short pickup.
Yeah, now maybe you bring in an extra defensive back or two, because you want to try and defend on third down. They like to play those nickel or sub packages, don't they?
And on third down, a nickel formation here defensively. Going to give to Gordon on the draw. It's a pickup of six, but it's not going to be enough. And the punt team's going to be summoned on fourth down.
And there's a run to be happy with. Good, solid yardage. You'll take that any time you hand the ball to a back.
To punt it away on fourth down, here's Drew Kaser. Tyreek Hill back deep for Kansas City. And this is away. It's a high kick, and he got all of it. And it's out of bounds. Now we'll see what the side judge says. He says out at the 8-yard line. Very tough spot here for the offense to start. They go play action here on first down. Escaping the pressure right. And he's taken down. Back at his own 7. And not a blitzer, but still able to get there from a strong safety position.
Yeah, I think that was a great example of what they call football IQ. Recognizing he was open, had a chance, and went ahead and got to the quarterback.
Looking to throw on second down. Smith. They'll leave this for Ware. And they'll get him down up past the 15, just shy of the 20. An 11-yard pickup, and it's enough for a Chiefs first down. Now a first down throw. It's Smith. It's Hill. Complete. And they're able to get this one across the 35. Another big gainer that time. This one goes for 19 yards. Smith on first down. He's going to leave this for his running back. It's complete. And some big-time hitting going on there. He is knocked to the ground right there at the 43.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, they can be a big part of any. Nowadays.
So we've got a second and 5. Possible run anticipation here as the D-line sandwiches together. Smith going to give this one to Hunt. And he'll get this up past the 45 to the 47. And give him about 4 on the play, but he's marked short, so it'll be 3rd and about the length of the football. They'll run again with Hunt. And some space here. And he goes out of bounds. It looks like right at the 50. It's a gain of 3, and it gets him the first.
I know the game's changed. A lot of people would say it's evolved. Look, I'm a little bit Neanderthal, okay? I love this. No exotic formations, no misdirection. Just line up and run the darn ball, pick up the first down. I love it.
Yeah, 3rd and short. That's what you're supposed to do. Like you said, old school smash mouth football. Now a play fake here on first down. And that is incomplete. His favorite target, Travis Kelce, the intended receiver. And now it's second down.
I know our vantage point might be a little bit better way up here, but that looked like an ill-advised throw to me. I didn't see anything open. And this play just didn't look right from the beginning.
It did not. I thought he might get outside and just chuck it away. Dangerous pass, incomplete. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
He kind of forced that one there, didn't he? It's almost like he predetermined where he was going to go with the football.
Yeah, he wasn't really going through progressions. He wanted to go to his top guy. You do that against this defense, they'll make you pay, won't they?
Yeah, they certainly will. They react very quickly to the thrown football.
And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete. So he can't hang on, and as I watch that unfold, I remembered an expression that I've heard, maybe from you, I don't know, but you're going to get hit anyways, might as well hold on to the ball.
Right, you know a coach said that, right? Yeah. Not an actual player. Not a chance at all. Way easier said than done.
And did they keep it in? They did. They kept it in. It's down close to the goal line at the one-yard line. And now out on the field, here comes Los Angeles.
They're going to have to go at least 50, 60 yards here if they want to ensure that they don't have to punt the ball like they did last time.
Yeah, so what you're saying is we're not playing to just get out of the shadow of your own goal line, right? You're playing to make sure the punter doesn't see the field again. So it's not picking up a couple of first downs. You want to pick up 5 or 6 first downs and make sure you move the ball into their territory.
Out of his end zone, Rivers. And it's a short one here, complete to the tight end. And able to get a little more breathing room out to the 5-yard line. That throw good for 4. It's second down. Rivers throwing over the middle, but it's incomplete.
You get a tight end like this, and you know he's used to dishing out punishment, but here, he's one that has to absorb the contact, and as a result, unable to hold on to the football.
Facing the prospect of a punt from their own end zone, they need some cushion. Let's see what they can do on third down. Back near his goal line, Rivers. And that is incomplete.
Well, the fans should be applauding this defense right now. It's an excellent job. They force a 3-and-out, and they should be able to set up their guys with great field position, probably near midfield or better.
So a short drop, but he's able to get it out, and this is a good kick. That's taken at around the 40. It'll be a 51-yard punt that time. And it's Chiefs football, first and 10. And now here comes Kansas City.
And, you know, their previous possession, they were able to move the football, but still wound up punting in the end.
You know, in 2016, Carolina had a 20-play drive that lasted over 10 minutes. And remember how it ended?
In a punt.
Yeah, I mean, how does that happen? You just don't see that happen every day.
This one maybe not quite that bad, but still, you'd like to have a chance for points if you hold the football that long.
Agreed. Well, you had to punt on your first drive, and on the first play of the second drive, you end up going backwards. I would dare say they need something good to happen right here, right now.
And he'll be taken down across the 50 at the 45 in enemy territory. Give him 13 yards there and a Kansas City first down. Smith with a give to Hunt. He won't find a ton of space following the display of power as he's down just inside the 45. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down. Under 4 to go now as the clock runs and they come up on second down. They go play action to Hunt. Now Smith. Harris has it over the middle. And he'll be knocked down sideways. A good pick up there of 20 yards.
I know I spend a lot of time talking about how tight ends in a lot of cases now are pumped up wide receivers, but they're still big people. And he used that frame right there to absorb a really big hit on him and held on to the ball.
They'll fake it. Now Smith. Throw left side, taken in by Hill. And he'll get it down this time to the 17. A gain of 6 there on first. Throw on second down. Smith. That's going to be caught at the 10-yard line. And he'll be taken down at the 2-yard line. A Kansas City first down. Smith finding Hill that time.
I like that one, partner. They go back-to-back with excellent gains. And really, it shouldn't be a surprise who they were throwing the ball to. He's their best guy.
Yeah, we knew that they would get him involved early. They're doubling down on getting him involved early.
Don't be surprised if they'll come right back to him again. They haven't shown the propensity to be able to stop him.
In motion, the tight end, Kelsey. Throwing again to Smith. This will be caught at about the 5. And he will take it on in for a Chiefs touchdown. Tyreek Hill, his fourth touchdown on the year. And the Chiefs are in for six. Oh, he missed the PAT. No good on the extra point, so a letdown there. And this will stay a six-point ball game. Butker now to kick this one away. And this will get out of bounds. No worries there, though. That still goes as a touchback. And now out on the field, here comes Los Angeles.
And this is their third drive. Maybe the focus right now, not so much on points, but getting their first down.
And when you start off a game, you don't even think that's an issue, do you? But you go a drive, a second drive, no first down, that becomes an issue. Now you got to think about, okay, what type of play calling do I have to do to get us in a spot to pick that first one up?
18 big yards on that one, and a Charger first. First down now, but that clock rolling.
He's been the forgotten man in this first half. Not a guy you want.
And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Justin Houston, in from his linebacker spot. He's able to drop him for a loss of about 10. Second down, Rivers. Oh, and this ball's tipped and intercepted. Picked off by the Pro Bowler, Marcus Peters. And the return this time will go out to the 42-yard line.
He's continuing to be a big presence defensively. Remember last week, AFC Defensive Player of the Week, and a big pick right there.
And when you pile up big numbers, it gets everyone's attention. But sometimes the number just needs to be, how many game-changing plays did you make? Did you take the ball away from the other team? He just did that, trying to win the award again this week.
Throwing is Smith. Under pressure, and he will go down. Sacked back at the 46.
Now the defense going to use the first of their timeouts. So as they take it over, we step aside.
The defensive line disperses a little bit here, maybe expecting a pass. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by Jahleel Adai. And he'll get this back across the midfield, striping down to the 47-yard line.
Brandon, this is a veteran quarterback back there. He should know better than to make a throw like this. This is definitely not his best ball. And I think he knew this was trouble the second it was leaving his hand.
Rivers now after the fumble recovery. Eluding the pressure right. Going deep here for Allen. And that one falls incomplete. Looked like he might have had position there, but he couldn't hold on it at second down.
I know he wants to get his team back in the game, but a 50-50 ball right there that maybe was a little questionable.
Yeah, he's pretty lucky to get that one back. I think that sometimes his quarterbacks play with a lot of confidence that borders on arrogance, and that can put your team in some dutch.
Yeah, especially maybe want to look at some safer routes after the interception he had that ended their last drive.
Wide open receiver complete. And they're able to get this one down to the 25. A good pickup there, a 22. Now Gordon on first down. And a short gain here down to the 22. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense as the clock will stop with 20 seconds to go in the first half. See if they stay on the ground for second down. From the shotgun, it's Rivers. Flushed out right. Thrown across his body and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 19. He's at the 50. 30. 20. 10. 5.
we know this defense has athleticism. Spots like that prove us right.
I love the way that you spotlighted the athleticism, because you and I both know the best athletes on the field, they play on defense.
Oh, I don't know. I was a kicker. You got to remember that now.
Come on. Come on.
Fine. And they turned the pick six into a pick eight with that two-point conversion.
I love how you upsell. That is outstanding right there. What a big-time play. Big switch in how this game was going, and then they capitalize a little bit on top.
This one fielded at the five. So we've come upon halftime here in Arrowhead with the Chiefs on top, as we'll send you down to Orlando as we check in with Larry Ridley and our EA Sports Halftime Report. Larry? So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number three. This will be fielded on the back line of the end zone. Out comes the Chargers as they'll go on offense now to start this third quarter. They come out here with a zero on the scoreboard. What was said in that locker room? That's what I want to know.
I would love to have been in there, because we often have the feeling that there's a lot of shouting, screaming, people upset. But typically, halftime locker rooms are a lot more clinical than that. And in this case, are they upset that the plays weren't working because of execution? Or did they think just they were just bad plays to call?
Yeah.
We'll find out pretty quickly here if they feel like they had something going, but they just need to do it a little bit better or not.
We'll find out. And some extras coming up on the line here, Redding for the blitz. Throwing again, Rivers on second and 10. And that's complete to the right side, it's Allen. And he'll get to the 29-yard line, brought down there. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down. And an extra DB here for the Chiefs on third down.
Pass situation.
Throwing Rivers. Sets up the screen to Gordon. And he will have a first down as they get him to the ground at the 37. It's an 8-yard pickup and leads to a new set of downs.
Let's give a little credit there. The offensive play caller sensed the screen pass was available. Whenever you're getting a lot of heavy pressure towards your quarterback, that's when you're thinking about running the screen and using that pressure against the defense. And it worked very well there for a first
down. And he's going to be intercepted a third time. Picked off at the 19. And a great return as he takes us up just shy. Interception, so maybe a second half tone setter.
Indeed, and not the tone they wanted to set. That's the equivalent of running out the wrong door and running into your pool instead of running out onto the field. A real dud for that one.
Has that happened to you before?
No, but I've heard stories about teams actually doing that back in the good old days.
After the interception, here's Smith. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. And he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. A good pickup there, a 22. On first and 10, Smith. Catch made right side by Wilson. The Chiefs have got the passing game rolling a bit, and another first down.
I think that's a big pickup for a first down, because when you run a drag route against zone, you're sometimes asking for trouble because you might run into a defender.
Yeah, well, there they ran into a first down, executed it to perfection. That's going to be caught at the 10-yard line. Back-to-back nice gains, that one for 14 yards and another first. This offense can certainly move quickly when they want to. Three plays, three pass completions. In the blink of an eye, they've got a first and goal.
Almost felt like a lightning bolt hitting this game, didn't it, for them to get downfield that quickly. And now,
and he is in. Touchdown, Kansas City. A great effort there. His sixth touchdown of the season. And the Chiefs add on to their lead. Still plenty of time left in the game, but now starting to pull away a little bit, get some breathing room with that one.
And I don't want people to think that NFL locker rooms are cookie cutter, that everyone's saying the exact same thing in every situation, but I do know that all 32 teams have an emphasis on starting fast, game being on the second half, no matter what, with his first 5 minutes, first three, whatever, this was a big score to start the second half.
And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. The Chargers offense now, they get set to head back on the field. They're sort of seeing themselves spiral out of control. Let's see if they can get things back on track.
And this is where the coach is walking that line of being calm and really being firm with his team. Had one tell me once, you know, we were having a tough patch. This too shall pass, this too shall pass. And finally kept having a rough patch. He said, but you've got to do something to make it pass. And that's what they have to do. They've got to get some control back, get themselves reasserted, and calm things down.
See if they can get calm and reassert themselves here. And now off to the races, down the right side. Touchdown, L.A. Tyrell Williams. His first touchdown on the year. And the Chargers are able to close the gap just a bit. That's the score you felt they had to have here in the third quarter to get back in this game.
And you know that there was an emphasis on their side. Hey, we know this. We know where we are. But sometimes that binds you up so much that you try too hard and you don't get the score. A perfect combination of urgency, yet relaxed enough to get it done.
They'll bring it back to just about the 25, call it the 24-yard line. And now here comes Kansas City. This is sort of what you would call a put-away drive, isn't it? They score here, especially a touchdown. It's almost out of reach.
It certainly feels that way, and I think that they're going to call their plays accordingly, because what you really want to do, even though you know the scoreboard is still up there and the game's going to go on, in fact, you can take the spirit away from another team. That their drive and will to come back and win can be taken with another score right here.
Still third quarter, but you just get that feel.
Yeah, they're teetering right there on the brink, aren't they?
And he's going to dump this off to his running back, Hunt. And he'll go down right around the 47 this time. It's a gain of 6 on the play, and it's a second down. Shipped together here from the D-line. They'll run it now out of the gun. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. It'll go as a gain of 10 and a Kansas City first down.
For so many years, I was convinced it was a myth, you know, because you always hear about the smaller running back. Oh, he gets lost. You can't find him. And sometimes that's part of his genius. But it's true. You get behind big offensive linemen. The defensive line guy's trying to find him, trying to peek around people to see him, and he gets lost, but this guy gets lost in a good way for his offense, picking up big yardage.
On second down, here's Smith. Steps away to his left. And he's going to get this inside the 30. Even after more than a decade in the league, Smith still one to account for with his legs as he picks up a first. So here we go, first and 10 now. They run with Hunt. And able to push his way forward here for a good little gain. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to 2nd and 4.
They're trying to show that they can run the ball and protect this lead. Give it to the backs, play a little bit of keep away, don't you think?
And that's probably a good philosophy at this point, going to make that defense stand up and stop them. And they're going to get him. He's sacked back around the 28. Joey Bosa. In there to get him for a loss of 5. Throwing on 3rd down, Smith. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up 4th down.
That would have been a great catch, but it's real difficult to hold on to it because it was contested all the way. Would have been a great play if he'd been able to haul that one in.
And the kick by Butker is good. And that will extend their lead even further. So he missed a field goal earlier, but he says not this time, and he's able to knock it through to give his guys 3.
And that's all you want as a kicker, a chance to redeem yourself. You got to have a short memory if you're going to survive at this level, and he's able to get back on track.
And now out on the field, here comes Los Angeles. And last time, the formula was pretty simple. One play drive, long pass. That maybe they just want to do that again, right?
And that's exactly how you want to draw things up, whether it's on your grease board, right, in your playbook. One play drive is exactly what you want on offense. What they have to be careful of is not having a letdown. It was real easy last time. They can't expect that going forward.
Yeah, we'll see if it's that easy here. And his pass is intercepted for the 4th time today. He's picked off near his own 48. And he will score. Touchdown, Kansas City. This D wanted to put it away before we even get to the fourth quarter, widening that margin a bit further.
And while they won't just empty the bench just yet, if you're a backup, start loosening up. I think you'll get a chance to play before this one is over now with that type of a cushion.
So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. The Charger offense making their way back out there. They have been struggling. I would imagine at halftime they went through some possible changes. Well, those changes aren't working, so now where do you go?
I think that now it's much more in their head. And what I mean by that is just what you said. You're going over the changes. I bet they were pretty clinical at the half, not too emotional. They might need to go to the emotional side because you've got to find something, some spark somewhere. And so far, just being calm hasn't exactly worked.
They need any spark at this point. Slot man moves right. On first and 10, Rivers. And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. And on that one, the protection just broke down.
You've got to have that leverage, don't you? We always talk about low man wins in the running game for an offensive lineman versus a defensive lineman. It's essentially the same thing in pass protection. Get lower than that defensive lineman so that you can keep your balance and keep him away from your guy trying to throw the football.
And he's going to go down again.
Well, this is what happens when you get behind the chains, as people like to say. When you have obvious passing situations, hard to vary it up and fool a defense.
And you hate those situations if you're an O lineman, right?
Oh, without a doubt, because you just know they're coming and you never know exactly how. They can be exotic in their blitzes, or their athletic ability just takes over.
Rivers now, flush to his right, going underneath for Gordon. And he is knocked down from the side, right around the 26. It'll be a gain of 6, and that's going to bring up a fourth down. Here's Drew Kayser now, as he's on to punt for L.A. He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. Fielded at the 20. And a big hit there as he runs into a brick wall. We're back now in KC. A lot of happy faces in the crowd at this point as their guys have a big lead here to start quarter number 4. They'll start with Hunt on the ground. Now that play is blown up, losing yardage back at the 35. It's a loss of 2 there, bringing up 2nd down.
I think it's pretty evident we can say what a difference a week makes. Last week, he ran pretty much wild, didn't he? Did pretty much what he wanted to do. But this one, they've stopped him cold. That, to me, that's good scouting and even better execution.
Yeah, and they stopped him behind the line right there. They obviously watched the tape a few times and made some adjustments. They run again with Hunt. And he'll be brought down right at the 45-yard line. It'll be a pickup of 10 yards. And that'll bring up a 3rd down.
Look, the first down marker is out there, but sometimes it's hard to find for an offense when they're in a long yardage situation, which usually means throw the football. In this case, they went against the tendency and ran it, and boy, the reward was there. A big, big pickup, and guess what? It's now 3rd and very short in order to try and pick up a 1st down.
They get 9 yards there, and they get a 1st down. They'll run it here with Hunt. And he's brought down. It'll go as a gain of 10 and a Kansas City 1st down.
Do my eyes deceive me, or is he getting stronger as this game moves along?
Burst seems just as good here in the 4th as it was way back in the 1st, doesn't it?
I do believe someone put a lot of time in the offseason and continues to condition during the season in order to continue to carry the ball at this rate.
And he's going to be run over, hit hard, as he'll be marked down. It'll be a loss of a yard, and that'll bring up a 2nd and 11. to throw is Smith. They'll leave it for Hunt, complete. And they're able to get this one past the 30, down to the 25. That one good for 12 yards into Kansas City first. And looking to put this game on ice in the fourth quarter, but still not afraid to throw it, as they show there.
You want to play the game with confidence, and they have a guy who's in control right now. Their trigger guy throwing it, they feel just as confident with him doing that as they would if they tried to run the ball and run the clock out.
And they've got it inside the 10 at the 8. 17 more yards on that one as they keep the drive rolling. The offense operating inside the 10 at the 8 here. It's first and goal. Here's Smith. Forced out to his... And he will score. Touchdown, Kansas City. Alex Smith with his second touchdown of the game and fifth on the year. And the Chiefs have got it on cruise control. And it's no good. It has not been his day. That's the second extra point he's missed so far. Butker now to kick this one away. This will be taken in at the 1. And his guys are going to start their drive right at the 20-yard line. And now out on the field, here comes Los Angeles. And with this deficit, you can't have too many more drives like the last drive where you had to punt it away.
You know what I would tell my offense right here? The punter doesn't exist, guys. He doesn't even exist. He's not a team anymore. I just cut him, all right? So you've got to go out and create some offense for us here and give us some points. No way does that guy get on the field on this drive.
Poor punter.
Yeah, it wasn't his fault. But hey, listen, there's got to be casualties at times. We're trying to win a game.
Rivers to throw it. And he just gets rid of it. Throws it away. A wise move there. Looked like nobody open. Now second down. Another wayward pass. You know, things started out poorly in this game, and to be frank, they just really haven't gotten much better.
And all that does is embolden a secondary. They feel good about what's going on, and they just play better and better.
Second down. They'll run with Gordon. And some room to roam now. And he takes this one just shy of midfield all the way to the 49. A big run there. 29 yards and a first.
I'd have to say that was a pretty darn good run right there. They had 8 in the box, still able to burn them. They've got to consider themselves lucky they don't give up.
Now a hit, and Rivers lost the football. And his guys are going to take over at their own 48-yard line.
And with that kind of a deficit, you can't afford to make any kind of mistakes. But it's been pretty symptomatic of what we've seen all game with them, isn't it? Down this big in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, you'd say an afternoon to forget, absolutely. And the D-line pinching together must be expecting the run. They go play action here on first down. Denzel Perryman coming hard on the blitz. He dumps him for a loss of 8.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line, flat out, cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
Here's Hunt. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 37-yard line. He'll wind up losing 3. And now it's third down.
Brandon, it's clearly a running situation when you're up in the fourth quarter. They're going to have to stack the box and make it difficult for them to move the ball.
Made it very difficult right there. Now they need to repeat that effort.
Yeah, bring 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take to slow them down.
And that one incomplete. Had some position but couldn't hold on, and it brings up fourth down. Fourth quarter, you've got the big lead. If you're coaching, Charles, you still taking shots like that downfield?
I'd be a little more concerned with running some clock and making sure you're taking care of the lead, because you keep flinging it around, you throw a couple of picks, you can put yourself in jeopardy.
And that's a 48-yard punt with the coverage holding him to 3 on the return. And it'll be Charger football here as they take over. The Chargers getting set to go, and the turnover last time, that's sort of been symptomatic of their struggles here in this one.
Big word. I like it, though, because you're exactly
you
right.
Like that, don't you?
All game long, they've struggled moving the ball, turning it over on the last possession, Is that word again, symptomatic?
Yeah.
I like that.
Your analysis, symptomatic of the success of this broadcast.
What I like is that you gave me the word, and I just kept using it.
And he motions the wide receiver. A second down throw for Rivers. He's going to loft one deep left side here. And that's caught inside the 30. There he goes left side. And he's across for the touchdown. Too little, too late. But he does get in for six.
No wonder you're grinning. You just beat me in our fantasy league.
Indeed I did, my good man.
Well, if you've got him in your fantasy league, you like his production, his second touchdown of the game. But right now, his team is trailing. Fortunately, he's playing pretty well and trying to keep them in it.
Yeah, they might need a little more from him here.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised if they continue to call his number. Right now, he needs his defense to step up and give him a chance.
And, oh, it's no good on the PAT, so they can't add on here. And our score is going to stay right where it is. Sturgis out now to kick this one off. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. Now the Chiefs offense, they get ready to head on the field. They have the big lead here late. They protected their home turf well, didn't they?
They certainly did, partner. And just think about how good that feels, because every team has a goal when they start the year to win at home. All right, and sometimes you don't win all of them, but they managed to get that done today. Just think about, your routine stays the same. Everything's familiar. You feel right going into the game, and they translated that into a win.
They did indeed. They protected the home field, and now the final stages. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. 25 yards the pick up there, and also a first down. And he's going to get this one down near the 45-yard line. A gain of 3, second down.
Not much happening there on first down.
I thought there might have been a hole for a split second.
Yeah, but it dried up pretty quickly, didn't it? Closed fast.
This is Hunt, and he'll be brought down at about the 42. Give him 3 on the run there. Now they're looking at a 3rd and about 5.
Looks like they're establishing a pretty good pattern here, because they've been very heavy in the running game on the last 4 plays.
Yeah, you took the words right out of my mouth. So far, 4 plays in this drive, all 4 on the ground. The Chiefs on 3rd down. They've converted just 2 for 6 thus far. This will be 3rd and 5. They'll toss it to Hunt, and he'll take this one down to about the 40. 2 yards on the pickup there. It's 4th down. This late in the game, Charles, I think you maybe seriously have to think about going for it.
Especially where they are in terms of field position, because this is almost like no man's land. Might hurt your punter because there might not be enough space, maybe too far for your field goal kicker. I'm like the old rule. Possession is 9/10 of the law. Possession is 9/10 of winning the game. Go for it. Get the first down. Close it out.
The Chargers offense gets set. They head back onto the field. They're down big here late. I don't know. You just one last drive here for pride?
Some people like to do that. I remember playing for a guy once. We were down huge, and someone said, "Coach, what do you want to call?" He just waved a hand like, "Who cares? Let's get out of here and do something some other time." But some teams like to do something at the end to feel a little bit better as they continue to move forward.
Yeah, probably just want to put this one behind them.
Brandon, just mark that under the category of just not successful. Trying to throw the ball, just didn't work on that one.
Completed it. No yardage. One last shot now for Rivers. Caught left side, Williams. And he's brought down, but not before they get it across the 20-yard line. Charles, we saw a lot of points go up in this one. Certainly defensively, stuff that they can look at on film, don't you think?
No doubt about it. And they've got to go back and check where the errors are, how they're going to fix them, and continue to get better at what they do. But they also need a little adjustment with their confidence. To give up that many points, even if you win a game, that can hurt you.
So for the Chiefs,
It'll be a 500 start as the win gets them back to 2-2. And they'll have another home date next week as the L.A. Rams come to town. Meanwhile, for our visitors, the defeat is their first of the year as they drop to 3-1. And they'll try to get back on the beam next week as they'll head to Cleveland to take on the Browns. So that'll do it. For my partner, Charles Davis, and the best darn crew in the industry, I'm Brandon Gaughton. This has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. The Chiefs victorious here as we say so long from Arrowhead.
Pulling up with the crew.
Oh my goodness.
Must have done same with the roof.
Oh my goodness.
You sitting looking stupid on the stoop.
Oh my goodness.
I would take notes if I were you.
Oh my goodness.
This was designed with the stars, the square and the cross, so we know true north.
Oh my goodness.
Smiling with 50 carats in my jaw.
Oh my goodness.
The law. It's a shame. Rhyme. It's a shame they let us jump out of Bentleys with dirty vans. Hit the stage for 15 minutes, get 30 bands. Swiss bank counting clean money with dirty hands. With some hood that's ready to with the. Since I came in, it made my name a name brand. French. Paris clubbing like a caveman. We threw up the pyramids, now they say we Illuminati. I'm a tsunami, what the f*** is a little Yachty? No blood diamonds, I rock gold like a king. Jewelry so cold, made them blow the nose off the Sphinx. You think I'ma be some type of role model? I go full throttle, desperado, that's the motto. Vic in Chicago, it's you half at the grotto. Brazilian motto, she mean mugging like Frida Kahlo. Drinking it with an Alicia Machado. I'm the ticket, you just hit the lotto. Pulling up with the crew.
Oh my goodness.
Must have done same with the roof.
Oh my goodness.
You sitting looking stupid on the stoop.
Oh my goodness.
I would take notes if I were you.
Oh my goodness.
This was designed with the stars, the square and the cross, so we know true north.
Oh my goodness.
Smiling with 50 carats in my jaw.
Oh my goodness.
The law. It's a shame. Rhyme. Young Vic the diamonds, finest. I shine like puff shine. Shine up I sign to the rock, cause I'm timeless. Top off the Mozzie, my behavior is mindless. On kids, we major, you mindless. Fresh out the cell to the booth. Drop the booth. I'm still in the hood. Tell shoot. Hope with a glove. The judge, you rappers is false flagging, you a fashion. What's cuz what you know about? What's V-Lo? Why Barry Lee, your head ringing? Free Vic Mensa, I'm a star, chain swinging. This that music, you can blame Reagan. I'm ball maying without paying. Y'all playing, we playing. My Himalayan. The lotto, that's the sacrificial lamb. I'm season cam, no matter blam. Pulling up with the crew.
Oh my goodness.
Must have done same with the roof.
Oh my goodness.
You sitting looking stupid on the stoop.
Oh my goodness.
I would take notes if I were you.
Oh my goodness.
This was designed with the stars, the square and the cross, so we know true north.
Oh my goodness.
Smiling with 50 carats in my jaw.
Oh my goodness.
Yeah.
The law. It's a shame. Rhyme. Crime.
Every other night I'm outside with the. You ain't got chips. Chip the world. You got chips. You could the next man's girl. Sounds harsh, but they've been ripped apart my world. The way Kiss told it should never be misquoted.
No.
That you wave on the camera, we've been toting.
Yeah.
Selling love potion my whole rap career. So your streams and downloads could never match the kids.
Never.
We could go foreign until it's boring. My sheep will keep jumping the fence until you're snoring. Street poetry, I'm more Wale for Lauren. Till the world is mine like Illmatic and Lauren.
Woo!
Written on a to a table full of fresh skin in the skin. Type of rappers we know got the right numbers on it. Burn a Carter down like I'm Nino.
Pulling up with the crew.
Oh my goodness.
Must have done same with the roof.
Oh my goodness.
You sitting looking stupid on the stoop.
Oh my goodness.
I would take notes if I were you.
Oh my goodness.
This was designed with the stars, the square and the cross, so we know true north.
Oh my goodness.
Smiling with 50 carats in my jaw.
Oh my goodness.
The law. It's a shame. Rhyme. Crime.
learn. I heard a voice of his broken hymn saying, nah, nah, this is who I am.
I know you ain't there yet. Don't stop to catch your breath. You're going higher and higher, higher and higher. Let go, set me free. Got the streets all I need. You're going higher and higher, higher and higher. Oh, keep running. Oh, keep running. Oh, keep running. Reach out, reach out. Oh, keep running. Oh, keep running. Oh, keep running. Reach out, reach out. Reach out, reach out. Reach out, reach out.
Boom, boom, can you feel the flame? Hold on, I can make it rain. Oh, do you hear the thunder? No, don't let it bring you
don't
down. Look up and see the light. You're not alone, don't give up like that. Oh, yeah, got a ways to go. Break that wall, let the spirit flow.
I know you ain't there yet. Don't stop to catch your breath. You're going higher and higher, higher and higher. Let go, set me free. Got the streets all I need. You're going higher and higher.
Polo to the float though, you already know though. It's Adamville for real, you see ya, just take a photo. I'm reppin' as I'm photo with a on your bro though. Cause that Jodo thought that he could rob a player for some Noto. Oh no, I'm so Allen Temple, I'm so England Manor, I'm so Misty Valley. And I got a couple yesterday out of Cali. And my bag from the valley bought me brand new balance. And I'm playin' with a no American dream. Man, she been riding since her daddy rode on four. I done in every hoe telling every I ain't with my wife, but if she meet her, might be a go.
Rick flap flashing. Don't I look dashing? Don't I look classy? Don't act so sassy. I'm the man, boo. That's with or without you. With what your say, show me what that.
I hear him talking reckless. I won't even stress. Just kill him softly with my press. Won't even address. They say I'm lonely at the top, but this the best. Hey, don't you see me out here shining, barely flexing. I hear him talking reckless. I won't even stress. Just kill him softly with my press. Won't even address. They say I'm lonely at the top, but this the best. And even if we die today, gon' live forever. Live forever.
Daddy pants ain't with three X's. Pick the X's. No X's on my chest, but all these diamonds got me blessed. Usually I don't do this. Dumb it down, go stupid. Since 17, been counting M's. My bank account's on goofy. Say, gave up. Now who know what the truth is? Chicago full of. My garage is full of hoop. This got that southern drawl and all that. My like ball bass. So I've got something to say, and all y'all can't get y'all ball back.
Fellas, we've got to have a great practice today. There's no other option. We've got 17 weeks. We strap it up and we get better each week. This is one of those times you got to take advantage of it, all right? So let's get at it.
Here we go. You ready?
Yeah.
man, that was great. I mean, you had taking the first steps to success in this league. But don't fall back and get lazy.
Bring them things. I bring them things. I call them all. Bring them things. Mojo. I bring them things. Looking so expensive. Rings and things. I bring them things. I bring them things. I bring them things.
Man, you don't want what I'm, bro. Oh, you, and you better get low. Extorting. You ain't got no friends. Oh, there we put that like a Chanel scarf like rainbow. $1,000. This ain't your cloth. You ain't. That ain't no sauce. I can see the noodles made for poodles. I'm thinking about the law Ferrari coupe. 1.8. The option is the roof. Greens is a secret to the youth. Your goals are malnourished. Peace fit the juice. Y'all be vaping, I be maiden. Yes. Y'all be aping, I'm Richard Mille Nation. No diamonds, just tourbillon facing with gears and sprockets with the sapphire casing.
When I pull up, they notice me. Come and talk to me like Jodeci. But don't you be too close to me. Them goons you see, let it go for me. I bring them things, I bring them things. I call them, he bring them things. Mucho. Bring them things, looking so expensive. Rings and things. I bring them things. I bring them things. I bring them things.
Here's a little story about a kid from Iraq. Had to show Carlito I was Benny Blanco.
Check it out.
Raindrop. Offset. Plug. Need an outlet. Child put me in the box. I'm in the box off. All of face shorty.